Jen. We're here at Cambridge Butterfly Conservatory. We're at the emergence room window. We're going to have a look and see what happens as our butterflies come out of the chrysalis and begin life here at the Butterfly Conservatory. Every week we import our butterflies from breeding farms in Costa Rica and the Philippines. The chrysalids that are in the window today have been imported from a breeding farm in Costa Rica. Every week we import approximately 1,000 chrysalids from these farms where they raise them in captivity to send to places like us all around the world. Butterfly farming is a great sustainable form of agriculture. When the butterflies arrive at the Butterfly Conservatory here in Cambridge, we unpack them and we make sure that they're healthy and they're not damaged. They come in all different shapes and sizes and colors, some very small and others very large. Generally, the size of the chrysalis is reflective of the size of the butterfly inside. And then we glue them very carefully onto straws, so we hang them in the same way they would be found if they were found in the wild. And we want to imitate nature as best we can, so that it's just like a tropical rainforest. You find the butterflies are inside their chrysalis about 2 or 3 weeks, and usually they're at least a week old by the time they get to us. So generally within a week of arriving at the Butterfly Conservatory, all of the chrysalis have emerged and the butterflies are flying around in the conservatory. When we look at the chrysalids, we see that they are many different colors and shapes. Some of them are very metallic in color. Shiny gold, look like a nugget. That helps to deter predators because they don't look like food. There's other chrysalids that look like the bud on a leaf about to burst open, and others that camouflage look like a dried up leaf. We have all kinds here, including some beautiful owl butterflies that emerge from the brown colored chrysalis that looks like a dried up leaf. They're hanging and drying their wings here for about 2 or 3 hours before they'll fly off into the conservatory. When the butterfly first emerges from its chrysalis, it actually pushes open a little door at the bottom of the chrysalis and essentially somersaults its way out and hangs on to that empty chrysalis shell. The body is filled with a lot of fluid that it then pumps into veins that are in the wings. In the process of pumping the fluid into the veins expand and then the wings expand. The butterfly then has to hang and dry its wings. The wings are really floppy and wet, like a wet spaghetti noodle. And it takes about 2 or 3 hours for the wings to dry and harden and for the butterfly to be strong enough to be able to fly. I hope you've enjoyed your behind-the-scenes tour of what happens at the emergence room window at Cambridge Butterfly Conservatory. I encourage you to come and see it for yourself. Best time to see butterflies emerging is first thing in the morning, and that's a great time to see them emerging from their chrysalis, drying their wings, and getting their proboscis ready and preparing for their first flight.